have seen many more like general surgery cases. Now as you come to orthopedic case, that is osteonecrosis of femoral head. Well, though it is a not common case. Our patient is a 39-year-old with married. He is a banker by profession. He has no special habits such as drugs, alcohol, and all. And he has been presented to a local clinic for the back pain, complaint of lower back pain, related to the left anterolateral side. This complaint has been there for 4 months. General physical exams finally arrived to our hospital was a temperature, night sign, like all the accommodations. He was advised tramadol and naproxen prescribed by the medical doctor for pain management following the onset of mechanical low back pain, the radiating to anterolateral side. Previous investigation, he was undergone an MRI scan in some other institution. It was his report was showing the protrusion of L4 and L5 in the L5 and S1 levels. Notably, at the time of initial presentation, the patient was not presenting with any either of big pains. Physical examination, when we did a orthopedic examination, decreased, like he was getting a pain over the flexion and approximately 60 degree of flexion, 10 degree of flexion, and 50 degree of plantar flexion bilaterally. And initially, then orthopedic test outcome, CAP stress was positive, trauma stress, instability test was also positive, modified trauma stress was positive. So we prescribed for the physiotherapy. After he undergone a physiotherapy treatment, he was not there for follow-up for around 3 months. He was not there. Then the patient suddenly one day came to our hospital saying severe hip pain with the lateral, which is radiating to an anterolateral side, which he was previously having. Then we performed. Then modified test, Thomas test, examination of left revealed the positive C sign, which shows that there is a pathology in the hip, acetabular joint. And second, he was getting a hip pain during the severe pattern positive test. Then for the anterior hip pain, the causes were like we have to rule out all these things: arthropathies, femoral acetabular impairment, anterior relaxed spine, septic arthritis, osteonecrosis. Then the hospital surgeon is recording for the MRI and X-ray. X-ray was showing a radiograph, and MRI was showing these findings. Radiograph and lateral demonstrated the collapse of the particular surface. Subjecting 6 degrees preservation of joint spaces, characteristic of osteonecrosis. And MRI was showing this left hip heterogeneous fascinus, femoral head, joint effusion was seen. Then he was advised for operation of the rotator cuff arthroplasty. Therefore, case description. The incident is more common across the world, even in India, around 18,000 to 20,000 cases per year. The underlying pathophysiology of reduction of blood flow, reduction of blood flow is the underlying pathology of this ONFH. Idiopathic ONFH is demonstrated the main predation then female. This form of ONFH though occurs in the abnormal fat metabolism, leading to a both marrow infiltration, producing the vascular compression and fatty embolism causing the internal obstruction. There is a very minimal and rigid available for this. Rapid onset of collapse, immediate in this patient has undergone a rapid collapse. So we took a immediate intervention because the guy in the classification, he was in a stage 3. So we did a totally part. Why this case? You need to be the involvement of collapse and contralateral hip. The rapid clinical progression of the disease, this current case is patient had restriction in hip flexion without a symptom that progressed stiffness and severe pain. This patient function over the period of approximately 2 months. At first, modified Thomas was positive. And we have seen all this. In this case, all the operative tests were highly affect you, welfare. And there is no specific guidelines for this. ONFH, in this case, highly two important features can be highlighted. We can highlight involvement of all symptomatic contralateral side must be excluded with the use of MRI. And ONFH can progress rapidly. Therefore, non-specific androgenic discomfort or pain in the middle-aged patient that is non-responsive to care should raise suspicion for ONFH even the absence of identifiable risk factors. So the differential diagnosis for androgenic pain, diagnostic imaging and treatment determination to aid in rapid diagnosis and treatment are recommended. These are the recommendations.
Thank you for the presentation.
This idiopathic femoral
lymphoma. We had a high PADL level, sir. Maybe that is the cause.
High?
Cholesterol level.
High cholesterol. Apart from this femoral head, any other bones can go for necrosis? Shoulder. Some of the causes, these are all the theories which have been put forward. That is, use of steroids. Suppose the bronchial asthma and other people.
We can avoid
in
those conditions. The
steroids
will ultimately lead to
the necrosis of this one. Yes. Steroids are culprit in some of them. And trauma. Childhood trauma is also one of the causes for these are likely etiological issues. So, in the initial examination when you are done, was there a restriction of the motor degrees?
Sir, this is why, flexion, happened degrees are and the flexion and movement, abduction and extension are normal. But the flexion and.
So, which movement will be impaired more, whether it is the flexion or extension?
Like,
what I studied and what I knew is visually the anti-gravity muscles, there will be the comparison.